What's up, YouTube? It's BBCast back in with another video and another reaction. And in today's video, we have this mother that got arrested by this cop for apparently walking on her driveway, I guess because her child or whatever was getting pulled over or something. So I'm going to watch it, get my reaction. Let me know what y'all think about in the comment section. And let's get into the video. Make sure to like, subscribe, and all that too.
I'm going to step on my driveway now because this is my child coming home.
Okay, nope. You think you go around? If you step on the driveway, you're going to jail because that's interfering with my investigation.
Your investigation is right there. My child is coming home.
Final warning. If you step on the driveway, you're going to jail.
Oh, that's not her child. My mistake. What the fuck though? The cop literally said you can't just stop. How does a driveway impede your investigation? That's so stupid, bro.
Take her. Nope, she's going.
No.
She's going to jail. You are under arrest.
And you're gonna lose your fucking job.
Stop. Don't tense up.
Are you kidding me right now?
This video shows Bellevue, Nebraska police arresting a woman for interference when she steps on her own driveway while recording a traffic stop. She was booked into jail where she spent about 2 hours before bonding out. The reason for the stop is the police allege that the driver had their high beams on. The reason for extending the stop is because the police allege that they smelled marijuana.
Jesus fucking Christ. Isn't there tornadoes going on, people who need help? And you guys are here? What the fuck? Oh, so no tornadoes hit Omaha and there's no houses destroyed, nobody. Okay. You're a fucking public servant. You work for me, you work for the public.
Right, for the citizens of Bellevue.
Yeah.
We can't go outside of Bellevue and do those type of things.
Oh, so you can't be a human being and help other human beings because you're too busy fucking stepping on somebody's rights?
Right now I can't. I'm paid by the city to be here.
You're paid by me to be here and you're arresting my girlfriend. Because his feelings got hurt. And you know, you just backed the blue, right? Blue line. You probably got a blue line somewhere. No? No blue line flags? You don't even own a shirt that has that? Huh. Kind of funny. He throws a fit over nothing. Somebody who's not scared of him. And then calls for backup. Now we got 4 fucking officers here. Why? So you're gonna arrest a woman standing on her driveway? Do you guys like ever like watch like the YouTube videos and stuff like that of cops who are doing something, someone comes up and records and then they get all butt hurt and try to arrest the person? Like do you ever see any of that? No? Happens quite often. And here it is happening right now.
That's the thing though, like even though with this officer being like really chill, the fact that he just let that happen is so stupid, bro, because it's her own driveway. Like what the actual fuck? And they, bro, that's so stupid. And you could tell his feelings even got hurt though, also because like as soon as she stepped, it's like take her. It's like I think they were really upset that she was recording, honestly. Because that's just so stupid to take someone to jail for.
So you're supposed to grab, book her in and everything.
It's not my decision. She was here. The officer who arrested her is this one right
so
here.
He is like the boss of everybody right now?
He has nothing to do with the boss.
Okay, but he like what I'm saying.
He establishes probable cause.
Do you, person to person, feel like her stepping on the concrete as opposed to the grass in her own yard is a reason to arrest her? Did you see her acting violently or anything of that sort? Because I didn't. Camera didn't.
So I do not view her only actions was to step from concrete to grass.
It was.
Being an instruction. But her overall actions, if you take them all into context, appear to be obstruction.
Her overall actions were doing exactly what I'm doing and recording and telling them not to speak to you. Because that is their right.
Absolutely.
Okay. So that we told them, hey, this is your right. And he said, you're obstructing. Shut up. I can't talk to these guys. Get out of here. And then you pull up and he says, if you step on the concrete, you're going to jail. So how is, I mean, you're on the concrete. What if I don't want you on my property right now? can you leave my property, please? Stand on the public street or the public sidewalk.
Unfortunately, I tried to stop coming from that. And your driveway is quasi-public.
Okay, so you arrested her for public property, private property, took her to jail for stepping from here to there. Like,
it wasn't just a simple action of stepping from grass to concrete.
Yes, it was. She did not say anything. She didn't act violently. She didn't scream. She just...
And this is the most... Honestly, to me, this is like the one of the most dangerous cops, because they could see their other fellow officer doing wrong and they just won't say shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, they ain't gonna say nothing and they just gonna let it happen. That's like, to me, that's just as dangerous as the ones that's doing wrong.
Just failed to follow his unlawful order that he's... Yeah. But you guys are out here on, like, you know it's fucking, there's no reason for it. You know this. Like, you can't admit it because he's your buddy, back to blue no matter what, but.
He's my supervisor, there's a difference.
Okay, your supervisor's fucking up. Call him out for it. Do something about it. Don't just follow in line.
And if I believed that he was, I would.
But so you think, her children are inside. They just watched her go in the back of a cop car. Why? Because she stepped on her property.
And again, it wasn't a simple action stepping from one spot to the other.
The camera, we watched it. His camera, your camera, everybody's camera watched her walk from there to there, me to you.
But it wasn't just because she walked from one spot to the other. It was the overall.
Overall, she had her phone. I'm being more vocal to you than anything she said.
And you can be as vocal as you want.
I know I can. It's my right.
You're
but
not,
what I'm
you're
saying...
You're not hearing with him anymore because you're talking to me. Does that make sense? And that's the only reason I'm up here, is if you have any questions or anything, I'd like to answer.
Well, you're not doing it because she needs to be taken out of the back of there before you guys go take her in and make this even worse than it already is.
And before...
Maybe you could go
happens,
speak with him.
And before that happens, my lieutenant will be here and you can have a conversation with him. Okay?
Can you have a conversation wherever this guy went? Can you go tell him, hey, you know, maybe we don't need to take this woman to jail. Maybe, you know, I get she didn't follow your order. She stepped on the concrete. But overall, she didn't do anything violent. You know, it was simply you created an imaginary line. And so if you step over this line, you're going to jail. That is not a reason to arrest somebody. And you know, you know I'm speaking reason. You just would want them to back you up if you were in the same situation.
I wouldn't want any of my officers to back me up if I was doing something.
Well, then why are you doing it for him? Why are you backing him up?
I have a claim to my man.
Yeah, and it doesn't make sense.
I observe probable cause to not be arrested.
Okay, other than why...
I feel like, and he's talking about, like, you know, you could be vocal and you can say all this, but he's saying, like, her overall action was for her. That's the reason why she's, like, behind, you know, in the cop car. That's so stupid, because, like, what the fuck are you talking about, bro? You talking about basically that this officer got his feelings hurt. That's all that he's really saying when he's, like, over her overall reaction. I just feel like all she was doing was recording and talking little shit. Like, it ain't nothing else to it. It's not like she went up to him and socked him.
Talking from here to there, what other actions did you observe? Because I was yelling at them, telling them what to do, more than she was. I was closer than she was. I'm being more vocal, loud, and everything else. I'm a man. She's a woman.
Right.
I would be the biggest threat.
To me, and I didn't see everything, and I wasn't here before, but she was taking this officer's attention away from this traffic stop, and then she walked past me towards the traffic stop.
On her property.
Right. But
this officer told me I have to get back in the house. He told me I can't come outside of my own house.
Right,
it doesn't make sense. She's walking on her property. Is there a law that says how close you can get to a traffic stop?
There isn't.
Okay, so you arrested her for his imaginary line, and he got upset because we didn't listen. That's exactly what it is. And then there's general human common decency, which all of you guys lack because she's sitting in the back of a car.
We're not doing anything indecent to her.
You got her locked up.
Right, we've arrested her.
Yeah, for nothing. She have cuffs on or zip ties or whatever. So you got her in torture cuffs, sitting in the back of a fucking cage for no reason.
I would imagine.
Why does she need cuffs on?
I the handcuffs would not be considered torture cuffs because
yes, they are
the same handcuffs that every officer uses on every.
Do you use them on yourselves? No, you don't.
Training, yeah.
Oh, training? Okay. This is a woman, no threat, walking on her property. Is that, there looks like there's somebody else over there. Is that the sergeant?
Lieutenant? I think he's gathering information before he comes across. Just so he's well informed, or as yeah. informed as he can be.
Yeah. Oh, these guys talk them out, hurt my feelings. And she stepped on her property from her property, and I made an imaginary line.
This dude funny, man. I ain't lying.
This is outrageous.
It is bullshit, though. I will agree with him on that. Because stepping on your own property is just fucking wild. All of them.
You got a woman in jail on her front lawn because we recorded. Our own private property. She took two steps onto the concrete because this supervisor here was butthurt. Wanted to give unlawful orders. He was scared.
With the police presence you see here tonight, you might think it's a murder scene. But it was a driver who allegedly had their high beams on and a mother that recorded the traffic stop.
That's another thing, too. I was realizing how many cops are here. Like, bro, I'm pretty sure there's so many other things that are way more serious right now that you could probably delete like one, two, maybe three of these officers that are here and like just leave like only like one, like two or three. Because I think it's like six of them out here.
I'm sorry, sir. I didn't catch your first name.
Nathan.
LT, this is Nathan.
How's it going? Hopefully you are going to do your job right today. I said, hopefully you're going to do your job right today and uphold the law.
I'll definitely do my job. What can I do for you?
Okay, so I don't know what they told you about her. Okay. She lives here. I live here. This is our private property. So there's a cop out front. We don't know what's going on. We step out, we record because that's what you do. You guys record us, we record you. Nothing wrong there. She was standing right here and we told the drivers, hey, you don't have to tell them anything. Don't say nothing. Then the supervisor guy, shut up. Go back in the house. You guys don't be out here. You can't be out here. You're interfering. I said, this is our private property. You can't tell us to go back in the house. We can stand here and record you. There's no law that says we can't. I didn't commit a crime. You know I didn't commit a crime. I'm not detained. Okay, so and hopefully you're going to do something about this. But he said he gets upset because I'm arguing with him. Clearly, I get people get upset when people argue with them. Sure. Shining into that here.
Sure. You're going to record me. I can see what you're doing with your hands. But go ahead.
Well, I know you can, but you're trying to obstruct the camera, which is a constitutional violation.
You have an actual... Okay, that's not...
No,
okay. You have an actual question for me?
So, she walked from right here to right where you're...
You know, this dude going to finna be a dick, bro. He ain't finna help this dude at all.
Standing?
Your girlfriend who was not involved in traffic stop, right?
No, nothing. She had nothing to do with it. We came out of the house... And he said, if you step on the concrete, you're going to jail. Okay. She stepped on the concrete. Okay. Now she's in the back of a car.
Okay.
So how is that? Why is she being arrested?
Well, let me ask you a question. So he was dealing with a traffic stop here where I can smell the weed from here where I'm standing.
Yeah. Okay. Had nothing to do with her.
Okay. But like this is what, 10 feet away? He said, don't come any closer. Or else
he said, step on the concrete. First, he said not to come out of the house. Okay. Then he ordered us to go back into the house. Okay. And I
because
said, no.
You were yelling at her. While he's trying to
we come out and he looked said go back in the house and said we don't have to, this is our property. We said, hey, you don't have to say anything.
Maybe that's why
you have the right.
Yelling, right.
No, we weren't aggressively yelling.
Okay. So he said don't come any closer.
She stepped on the concrete, they put her in handcuffs.
And therefore she did, and now he's
so
man, this bitch ass. I knew he was finna be a dick, bro. He laughing talking about for instructing with his old grinning ass, bro. They all evil, nigga.
How do you have jurisdiction to arrest somebody because they stepped over an imaginary line that you created on their own property?
For officer safety, he says, don't get any closer.
Officer safety? No, okay. I don't need to because you're okay. Giving me your bullshit okay. Answer. Right. You got guns, badges. What? Hey, what was your name and badge number again, please?
Are you willing to listen to an answer?
If you're going
to
give me your name and badge number.
Okay, I'm Lieutenant Mercer with the Bellevue Police Department. Okay.
OK, Okay.
Make a number. We go back to numbers, not badge numbers. It's 251, okay?
Okay.
So you call and make a complaint. Just call down Bellevue Police Department any day of the week, Monday through Friday. Say you want to make a complaint. They'll send you up upstairs to do so, okay?
See, and this is...
And then you can talk to them and tell them what happened. He's going to look at Sergeant Markby's video and anyone and everyone else's video who was here. And they'll explain to you, I guess, the laws and the Constitution. And kind of go from there, okay?
Well, there's going to be... If you guys are going to take her to jail, there's going to be a court case over this.
Of course. She will have a court date. Oh, that's how that works.
No, like, there's going to be a lawsuit.
Okay. You do whatever you need to do.
Can you honestly tell me you think she needs to go to jail for stepping from me to you?
Here, but if she did not listen and got any closer and he told her literally exactly what was going to happen and she decided to push her luck and do that?
What if he said, don't sit down?
I got to work on my pausing, bro. This dude trying to say, like, what the fuck? You're talking about, like man, this will look
bad. You're going to jail and I sat down. Because
I can't get over that.
What?
I can't get over that, bro. I'm sorry. Like, that kind of bothers me on why he did that.
Push your luck and do that?
What if he said, don't sit down?
Like, that's such a dick thing to do, bro.
Or you're going to jail and I sat down because I was tired of standing.
Or coming closer
what,
to him interfering.
What he did is not reasonable.
Okay. Do you have any questions? Not reasonable. Do you understand how to file a complaint?
I just don't understand why
she will have a court date.
Five officers
she will have a court date.
Out here for a woman.
Okay. And you and the two people that were in the car. So four of you.
I was louder.
Four of you guys.
I was more vocal. I was more mouthy. I told them more. I was closer. I'm a male. She's a female.
Did you any, get closer?
Any general person.
Or did you actually?
I started from my front door when he told. No, he told me to go back in the house when I walked out my door. I didn't.
And he didn't arrest you for that?
No, he didn't. But he arrested her.
Because she got closer than he said to, right?
He said, you step on the concrete. What if. I mean, we got to go on the concrete to get back into our house.
Does that make sense? Over there?
What, this doesn't make sense.
Okay. Again, is there anything else I can try to explain to you? Because
I mean, you could let her out before this has to go.
She's going to jail for obstructing a peace officer, okay?
Wow.
You can look up that you can look up that statute and read that for yourself.
I already know. Okay. Wow. Fucking worthless, cock-sucking pieces of shit.
Man, honestly, overall, my whole opinion on this, bro, that was some bullshit. And then even with this damn lieutenant coming, talking about, like, all this, like, bro, he was being such a dick to that dude, bro. Like, you already know the supervisor. He's the one that arrested that lady. So you already know that the lieutenant might not be any better. So that's why it's like, bro, like, whenever they say they're going to call the supervisor, lieutenant, you really got a 50-50% chance if they're going to be, like, on your side or not. You do have cases that you do have a lot that are... for the citizens and they do correct the officers. Then you have other ones like this where they're like, it is what it is. Like, bro, fuck you. Like, what the fuck? But that's overall my whole opinion on it. It's definitely stupid that the fact that they arrested her for just stepping on her own property. I mean, they say, okay, like the Travis stop was here and all that, but it's like, bro, be for real with yourself. Like, I really think that she was like talking shit and he didn't like it. I really think that was the case, honestly, and all of that. And like I said, you have that other officer right here, that was talking to him, and he's one of them that just ain't gonna say nothing. Like, he won't, most likely won't do wrong, but if he sees other officers doing wrong, he ain't gonna say nothing. That's the type of vibe he was giving me. But, let me know what y'all think about this video. Make sure to leave it down in the comment section. How do y'all feel about these officers' actions, towards this lady and all that? And just let me know what y'all think, and y'all have a wonderful day.